There are loads of different fiber connectors, and one could assume that if you're mating two fiber connectors of the same type, that everything will be working just fine. But that's not quite true. If you want to find out more, stick around and we'll check it out. You've probably guessed it, we're talking about ferrule polishing of the connectors. In other words, we're talking PC, UPC and APC. But before we get to talking about the different polishings, let's talk about the why. Why do we have these different polishings? And basically, it always boils down to that every single time we have a fiber connection, that fiber connection has a negative impact on the optical performance of the optical signal. Namely, we've got the insertion loss, so the loss of optical power, and we've got the return loss. So in other words, the amount of signal, the optical signal that is being reflected back to the light source. Now these different polishing techniques, they are actually to compensate these negative effects. Let me explain. Now the first fiber connections that we had, the first polishing was a flat polishing. And the point is that with that flat polishing, when we mated two connectors, you can see that we've got this huge big area that is touching. And that means that any, even the slightest impurities of the surface accumulated, meaning that it wasn't really possible to have a perfect mating of it, meaning that we always had a relatively big air gap, resulting in bad insertion loss and return loss. Now to compensate that, we then had the PC, so the physical contact polishing. And the PC polishing has a spherical design, so it's slightly rounded. And the result is that if we mate these two connectors here, you will see that we, instead of having the big surface, we've only got that very small surface in the middle that is touching. So in other words, that negative effect that we had of those big surfaces was then removed with the physical contact, meaning we've got to have an improved insertion loss and return loss. Now the next evolutionary step after the PC was then the UPC. So in other words, the ultra physical contact. And the difference between PC and UPC is that the UPC goes through a far more extensive polishing process, and the result is that the finishing of the end phase is much finer, once again improving the insertion loss and return loss values. Now, if we get to UPC, the insertion loss is already very good, but the return loss, that still has some room for improvement. So that is then where the APC, so the angled physical contact connector and polishing, comes into play. Let me explain over here. So if we have a look at these two images, we've got the PC connector down here, or the UPC connector to be correct, and the light coming in here will hit upon this 90 degree angle, meaning that the light being reflected will be reflected straight back into the fiber cable. And the trick of the APC is that this the end is slightly angled, which is an 8-degree angle to be precise, and the light coming in here then hits upon that 8-degree angle, and that is enough so that the light being reflected won't be reflected into the fiber cable, but instead into the fiber cladding. And the result is that we have a much better return loss. Now, of course, a deadly sin is to try and mate UPC or PC with an APC. And the reason for this is that you will actually have them only contacting here, that single point, and the spring-loaded ferrules will be pressing on that single point, and the result is that you will be destroying the polishing of both connectors. So how do we keep them apart? Well, basically the rule of thumb is that the UPC and PC connectors will have a blue element to the connectors, and the APC will have a green element to it. Okay, one last thing we need to clarify. So we've got these cleaning cassettes, and these cleaning cassettes, you open them up and you've got that silk band inside, and you swipe the connector across that. So how does that work with the APC? Because now we've got an angled connector swiping up against that silk band. And as you can see here, that we have an offset between the silk band and the fiber connector at the highest point of that angle. And the good thing is that the silk band is actually cushioned, meaning that if you press it in, even at a 90 degree angle, the connector, the full end face, will be touching that silk band. So in other words, you will still be perfectly cleaning an APC connector with those cleaning cassettes. Now, of course, the big question is, why don't we just always use APC connectors? I mean, good insertion loss and also even better return loss. Well, as usual, it normally boils down to that one deciding factor, and that is cost. Because the manufacturing process of an APC connector is that slightly bit more complex, meaning that the cost of an APC connector generally is that little bit higher. So in other words, APC is then more used in areas or in applications where the return loss is a very important factor. So when we're talking about things like FTTX and PON networks or RF signals. And UPC is then used everywhere else. So I hope you learned something today and that you enjoyed this video. If so, please leave a comment. And of course, remember to follow our channel so that you get your regular dose of brain snack. Until then, bye-bye.